this week that an enemy company that's been targeted announced that it was offering a $500,000 reward for information leading to the bombers. But really, the ongoing story hasn't made much front page news at all, despite investigators warning that each successive bombing is getting closer to populated areas and calling them, quote, increasingly violent, end quote. So our question to you, point people, and to the nation, of course, are we taking the kind of bombings seriously enough? Shelly, what do you think?
Well, somebody in Alberta where, you know, if you think of the way that Google owns Northern California and GM in some ways owns Ontario, well, we can't own BC and parts of Alberta. And it makes you really think about the informed consent that we as a population are being asked to give when it comes to things like pipelines and satellite gas wells and drilling and the management of our land. And so for the first time, I'm in no way saying that it's a good idea to decide whoever did it is from a this issue. It is giving us as people an opportunity now to think about what's really going on at North and how the land is being used and what's going on there. And if it's a danger to people who live, you know, within the sour gas area, it's a danger to us as Alberta's Canadians and citizens of the world.
Well, what about the threat itself and, of course, what's happened so far, Vern, in terms of the bombings and not this type of story, the domestic terrorism, as we're assuming thus far, will play differently than other countries, say the one just south of us.
States, of course, there'd be all kinds of media attention on that, and it would really be brought to the forefront. But I think what's happening here in Canada, you know, I don't know if it's our attitude, but you know, we're basically out of sight, out of mind, you know. It's up in a remote part of Canada, you know. It's you know, it doesn't really affect too many people, a lot, you know, that sort of attitude. I think their attitude.
Of 25 people.
doesn't affect a large population. I hate to say it, like, it just doesn't not scary enough people. And then, of course, the other attitude is, well, you know, it's in Canada. You're a multi-billion-dollar company.